You are about to meet two unique athletes, Ann-Marie Saccurato and Angel Bovee, female competitors in one of the most aggressive and male-identified sports on the planet, boxing. These two women have made a different choice than many elite athletes at the peak of their competitive careers. They are out and proud, pioneers in the ring. You know, I've been a boxing fan all my life. It's a pure, simple, compelling moment when two equals step into the ring and face each other with nothing more than their lightning-quick feet and artful punches. When it's a fair and even bout, those of us outside the ring witness a dance of beauty, and in the end, we clearly see who has shown the most heart. Ann-Marie Saccurato is on a focused mission to reach her absolute peak of physical and mental endurance. In 1 month's time, she will face a monumental test. She will come to know if she has what it takes to be a world champion.
Well, I got money in the bank, and I got a car to drive, and I got a working set of hands that my guitar seems to like, 'cause I got a love that won't quit, and I got time to rest, and I got a clear, able mind that sees my life going. Cause everything I need is right here in my hands, right here in my hands, right here in my hands. Everything I need is right here in my hands, right here in my hands, right here in my hands. Well, everything I need.
Yeah.
Nice. I was never good at ball sports. I just happened to be good at boxing. I wish I was good like a swimmer or a golfer or something, but boxing just seems to be what I'm good at, which is unfortunate.
Where I was, and everybody begs me to go back to basketball and volleyball, but this has taken my heart, it's taken my passion, something about it that I have in this ring that I haven't had on the basketball court. Or the volleyball court.
Boxing is the ultimate test. Boxing is the ultimate test of what you have inside of you. Not just your physical strength. What's your heart like? How bad do you want this? How much are you willing to give? How much are you willing to sacrifice? How much are you willing to bring into that ring? You gotta dig deep within you for what you want to get that win, to get that victory. Just like in life.
You jump to that. Hey. No, you jump to that.
It's very loose. The power.
Yeah. Bam, beautiful. That's great. Good, good. Beautiful.
Step
right there.
Come in and step in.
Right. Right.
That's why you're
fine. I like my fight. I can box, I can fight back. So right now she's getting ready because she's very tough. Yeah. Good.
Yeah. Bend down a little bit. Chin down. Chin. Yeah.
That left hand, the wrist had to turn more.
Position yourself, you're off balance. Okay, body. Bing, back. Bing, back.
Work, baby.
You see her sometimes grunting in the ring? This comes from the soul, from inside. Some people are born genetically different than others. She got a gladiator genes. That's the difference. Some people are born to be gladiators. Some people are born to be artists. It's So that's what makes a fighter, that gladiator spirit in him. And she got it. She definitely got it.
Good. That's it. She's doing beautiful. She's going to be a champion.
After 2 years on the amateur boxing circuit, Ann-Marie turned pro and racked up an impressive 11-1 record, becoming one of the top-ranked females in the country. But a shot at a world title eluded her, until a fight in Edmonton, Canada fell into her lap, leaving just weeks to prepare for the most demanding challenge of her career.
It's great.
I love this game, I love the sport. I love training, I love pushing myself to the extreme, to just keep going and going, you know? That's why I love these guys. It's the first time I started working with Sharif, and the first time that I met him, and that's incredible. That's what I want. I want a team behind me that's gonna keep pushing me past where even I think I can go.
At age 18, I was involved in a very serious car accident. I was in the back seat, and the car hydroplaned, and I was sleeping. And we spun off the road, we hit a pole, and on impact, they found me halfway outside the back window of the car.
The doctor said she might not live the night. By all accounts, Ann-Marie shouldn't be alive today.
I woke up, and the first words out of my mouth, mind you, I have a priest in front of me, I have my family around me, I'm in a hospital bed, all kinds of injuries. First words out of my mouth, what about sports? And the doctors told me they didn't think that I would walk again or walk normal again, but I knew that I'd be okay. I had two broken legs, I had nerve damage, I had no feeling in my left leg whatsoever from my hip down. Broke my right hip bone, I broke basically every rib on my right side, punctured my right lung. I shattered my right arm in 5 places. I have a metal plate holding this together. I have a metal rod in my right leg and a metal rod in my left leg. And I tore apart my chin in several directions. I had one free arm that wasn't injured, and with this arm, I had them tie resistance bands to every corner of my bed and just doing whatever movement I could and just kept pushing myself, pushing myself, pushing myself.
And I think that has given her courage as far as her boxing is concerned. Why be afraid of an opponent in a ring when, you know, look what she's faced? Why be afraid of, you know, being gay bashed because look what she's faced? I mean, it's all small peanuts now when you've faced death and come that close.
After her accident, Ann-Marie searched for a workout program to rebuild her shattered body. One day, she stepped into a boxing gym and discovered her passion. Her early success in the ring came from raw willpower and the love of competition, rather than finely tuned boxing skills. Uncoached and self-taught, she was a sloppy and wild fighter.
When I first started boxing, I was a big brawler. I was a Tasmanian devil in the ring, just trying to survive, come out with the win. Brawling is just craziness, arms flailing in the ring and just running after your opponent and making no sense of your punches and ugly. It's just ugly, just standing there and slugging.
Ann-Marie knew that brawling was not going to take her where she dreamed of going. To compete against the best boxers in the world, she would have to train not only harder, but also smarter. She designed an innovative training program that worked every muscle set used in the ring and pushed herself to a world-class level of endurance.
Take little time, you do it.
Ann-Marie then found a coaching team that showed her how to box rather than just flail her arms.
Low, you carry your hands a little low.
Okay.
Pick them up.
Boxing is science, very technical. Everything is measured. Every step is measured. Every punch is measured. The correct form, and the power is delivered behind the correct form.
That's beautiful.
The jab in boxing is what starts everything off. The jab sets up your combinations.
My jab I'm gonna use to gain respect in that first round. I'm pop it out nice and strong, nice and relaxed. I'm gonna use it to keep my opponent away from me, whatever distance I want them at. I'm gonna use it to break their rhythm if they try to get into a rhythm to throw an attack on me. I'm gonna use it to get in their head, just frustrate them.
Right, that's it. Right. Hi, good, beautiful. That's it. Step over. Hi, beautiful. Move your body. Don't walk like that. Right. Get close. Don't go back. Get close. Side to side, that body. That's it. Move your body. Right. Move fast, body. That's not move body. That's skipping punches. Move your body. Stop that. Move your body. Move your body. You're not moving your body. Fast. Step.
Boxing seems like it'd be a very simple sport, but what happens then at 20 feet by 20 feet in the ring can take such a long time to learn.
Turn that back foot. Your hand has to be out of you. Step.
It's not about two people standing in front of each other and slugging it out. It's about evading and returning and the offense and the defense, and it has to flow seamlessly together. So footwork and moving in the ring is really the key to our success. Just being shy of somebody's punching zone. If they throw a punch and they end here because you took a half a step back and then you come right back in and, you know, they sit there scratching their head wondering why they didn't hit you.
Hey, you not to do so much. Only walk. Look, walk. You're doing all this. Walk. Or you walk in the street, like this?
I'm not doing that.
You're doing that. You wanna move from here. You sit back and then you're moving. Huh? Look, what I said about your foot. Stay in your foot.
When Hector works me in practice, he is a perfectionist, and he wants nothing but the best for his fighters. So everything has to be precise.
He yells a lot, he screams a lot, but the technical aspect that he has really added a lot to our games. So you kind of take one for the other.
Hey, step. Again, wait. Step. Wait! Relax. Get your position.
Who else is fighting this from New York? Melissa Hernandez?
I have to check the card. All I know is Melissa.
Women's boxing is a poor stepchild to the male side of the sport. Like most female boxers, Ann-Marie and Angel do not receive big fight purses nor endorsement contracts.
Yeah, I have other fighters.
On top of training, this boxing couple must act as their own managers, promoters, and publicists.
Melissa.
In this sport, you have to be scrappy. You have to have determination as a woman boxer or you'll never make it. You know, I'm not just talking about inside the ring, but outside of the ring. If you don't have that never say die attitude, you're just not going to get anywhere because this is a frustrating sport. It's not just her fight, it's my fight too. And when I'm fighting, it's not just my fight, it's her fight. We couldn't do it without each other. I mean, nobody would take care of that other part, you know, if we weren't there for each other. We're connected at the hip all the time.
If we can get a good fight photo, probably, but I want to have a backup.
I like this one, because it looks like you look now, you know?
Most female boxers have a day job to pay the rent, which often means training at the end of a long work day.
Okay, sorry.
Arms straight out in front of you.
Ann-Marie has found a more flexible solution as a personal trainer, where she inspires her clients to relate to their bodies in new ways.
That's it. Too good. I've tried to give them what's inside of me. Show them courage, show them strength, show them that they're capable of doing things.
Excellent, much better.
I'll try to breathe, but...
It's not what they do here, it's what they do outside of here and how they perform. And if I can make them stronger inside, then my job is complete.
Deep breath in, exhale. You breathing?
Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah.
Deep breath in.
Oh, God.
Exhale, relax.
You see how I'm tensing my shoulders?
You're tensing everything.
Relax.
If you tighten up, what's going to happen?
I can't help it. It's at a point that hurts, really.
It hurts your stretches. Two different things. I'm barely moving you. Okay, watch where I can cross. Deep breath in. Exhale. Relax. Much better. Good.
Oh, my God.
Sit.
Yay! I haven't had my leg over like that since we started.
I won't break you. Relax.
1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 6. That's it, 2, 6, 3.
Angel teaches boxing as exercise when she's not fighting. As an amateur, Angel has won every title possible, including the U.S. Nationals 2 years in a row, the New York and National Golden Gloves, and in 2002, she led Team USA at the World Championships in Turkey. She dreams of Olympic gold, but boxing for women is not included on the Olympic calendar. As a board member of USA Boxing, Angel lobbies for the day women will compete on the Olympic stage.
Angel's amazing. It's very special to be in a relationship where the two of you are striving for these goals and up against these challenges and to be able to push each other and help each other get there.
That's it, again. Good. 2, 3, 2.
What's it really like to be a boxing couple?
Oh, boy.
It sucks sometimes.
It sucks bad.
It sucks because there'll be times where I don't have a fight. She has a fight, so she's training, she's watching what she's eating, you know, and then the tables turn and I'm fighting and, you know, she's able to do whatever. You know, we miss out on vacations, we miss out on enjoying a lot of life because it's, you know, it's constantly taking a toll on our time and, you know, the amount of time we put into training and what you have to eat and how much time you have to actually spend with each other, quality time you have to spend with each other. So it takes a toll. But
it keeps us poor, which, you know, is no fun.
It keeps us very poor.
And a lot of times Ann-Marie can't go to my fights because she's training for a fight that probably won't happen, but she's training anyway. So we spend a lot of time apart. And then I just think back and I think that, you know, if it wasn't for boxing, we might not have met. So
yeah,
it's pretty good sometimes.
Conceals me like, no one reveals me like my lover.
I grabbed the boob, I didn't know that was coming.
No one can disconnect, no one can resurrect like my lover.
Sometimes I feel like that song, My Lover, I wrote. Because it so perfectly symbolizes my relationship with Ann-Marie.
My lover takes me home, cools the rolling stone.
Ann-Marie is my missing piece. She's passionate, she's fierce, she's loving. We talk without speaking. She just completes me.
When I first met Angel, I knew she was something special. I met her in Midland, Texas at the U.S. Nationals boxing. 2 years later, we met up again in Gleason's gym in Brooklyn, and the electricity in the air when we both saw each other, there were sparks everywhere. We were both bouncing off walls. And, you know, we hooked up the next day to spar. No, we really did. She called me, we sparred the next day. That was on Friday, and then she left my apartment on Monday, and she kept coming back. And I mean, really, it's been magical. Sometimes we'll get the sarcastic remark here and there for being affectionate in public or whatnot, but you know what? This is bringing being a gay athlete and being out, being open to the table. That's part of our goal, that's part of what we're trying to accomplish.
Out lesbians tend to be on the cutting edge of things. So in boxing, the last bastion of the male world, you're seeing females start to creep in. So just being an out lesbian, we were the first ones to kind of push that door down just because we're used to not having to, you know, fulfill society's norms on what it's like to be a woman, not having to look a certain way, not having to behave a certain way, and being afraid, you know, if we don't behave that way, the repercussions. I mean, we're used to shaking it up in society. So this is just, you know, our way of doing it.
Ann-Marie and Angel face serious obstacles as women entering the sport of boxing, striving for the same opportunities and recognition as the men. But the fact that they were lesbians in an open and loving relationship was surprisingly not an issue.
Boxing traditionally is a very accepting place. I mean, it was the first place, you know, African Americans and, you know, Caucasian people could be together. Historically, men, you know, they would fight, they would train, they would have the same training facilities, they shared the same ring, when out in society, that was not the case. So for us, other boxers are probably our biggest allies.
When I walk into Gleason's and you get just so much love from the guys that are there. Everybody wants to hug you, kiss you, support you. They joke around with you. They joke around with both of us about our relationship and say funny little things to the both of us to try to get us going or whatever. But it's great. It's more like a family atmosphere.
Boxing gym is a very different space. You gain your respect by years put in. It's not an issue of if you're gay, straight, black, white, whatever.
Stand up.
You're going in those ropes and you're sweating and bleeding just the same as everybody else, and that's where the respect comes in.
Back. Back. Push your back.
There's many people that walk into that boxing gym that, you know, don't last a week or don't last a month. And it's the ones that last. It's the true warriors that stay. Go get it. And I respect every single person that steps through those ropes because it's hard as hell. Boxing's the hardest thing I've ever done.
Beautiful.
It's not an easy sport. You don't play boxing.
That's awesome. Looking good. You're looking good.
Thank you. They respect us because we can box. You get much more respect because you can box than anything else in the gym.
Being out and at the top of their game has earned these boxers a growing fan base, both gay and straight. Before they knew it, they were role models.
Just because we were out, people would gravitate towards us who were closeted. People that are wrestling with coming out, or even wrestling with are they gay or are they not gay. And I can't tell you how many people started training with us. We thought because they wanted to train with us, but it turns out they were on the verge of coming out themselves.
Once you see the impact you have on somebody, or somebody even writes to you and is telling you this issue that they're dealing with or struggling with, and to be able to help them, and just the simple fact that they actually came to you, it means a lot to us. And we're always like, we sit back afterwards and we're just like, wow, look what we're doing.
And it always comes at the right time. We're having a crappy day. Just the other day, we're having a horrendous day. Why are we boxing? Why are we, you know, we're wasting our life and the whole, you know, well, how are we going to retire? We have no money, blah, blah, blah. So we get on MySpace and here this random person we don't know writes us and says that she read about us in Curve or Girlfriends and that, you know, we really inspired her to start boxing and, you know, to come out.
I never fought for a second with who I was or what I was about. I never fought with being gay. I said, wow, this can't be. No, maybe it's just this one girl in particular. To me, it just, who you love is who you love. And I wish I could bring that to the world. I wish the world could see that, because why is that wrong?
I see so many people in this world that live with fear of all kinds of different things. And I'm not choosing to be one of those people. I can't live in fear. I mean, I used to be afraid of different things, and I feel like it's no way to live your life. You have to take risks. You have to be on the cutting edge. You have to be free.
The best preparation for a title fight is sparring, and the optimal sparring is against elite boxers. IWBF champ Missy the Fury Fiorentino arrives to go 8 rounds against Ann-Marie, protected by padded headgear to prevent injury or knockout.
Jab, come on. Use your jab. Beautiful, that's it, baby. Jab. Punch me straight through, baby. Hey-ya! Beautiful. Nice.
Step back with the head.
Beautiful. Hi. Beautiful. Don't you? Come on, work.
Right there.
That's it. Hey-ya!
My jab needs to come out a little more.
You look like you're pushing your punches a little bit there.
Yeah, I was trying to get my range, but this is so much shorter.
Don't make me move. Touch it. right away. Bye.
Shorty punches.
Come on, work. Work.
There you go. Right hand again.
Take that hand from back there. Keep punching. Don't stop. Keep punching. Keep punching. Step back. Step back. Step back. Right there. Oh,
that's
right. Oh, you could have knocked her out right there.
She was like six shots.
I saw her eyes go back, and I backed off.
Yeah, but that was six unanswered shots.
I know, that's why I backed off after her. She was hurt. I saw her eyes go back when I landed that right, and I said, that didn't mean to throw. I mean, you know, it was just perfectly
that was a good
placed.
One. That was perfect.
That's it. That's it. Good. Good. Good job. What you do here, that's the same thing you want to do in the fight. You want to hurt that girl, and then you want to start looking at her, playing.
A lot of times I try too hard. Hector's giving me advice in the corner, and I want to perform the right thing, but I try too hard, and that screws my game up. When I learn to just relax and feel my flow and let it go, I come out a lot better. My shots are more precise, and they're more effective. So if I can just keep my cool on the fourth and just stay relaxed, keep my composure, and just let it flow, it's going to be a good night for me.
Very good. Very good.
Trying too hard to win has been Ann-Marie's Achilles heel ever since her days as a brawler. This will be Ann-Marie's first 10-round bout against an opponent who already holds 3 world titles. She realizes if impatience overtakes her boxing technique, it could cost her the fight in Canada.
Good, very good.
You're just a great fighter. This is your chance. Come back with the win, that's it.
You know?
Edmonton, you're alone tonight, looking for your exit plan. Wasted mornings with the wrong old man. Reach out and take a hand. Time to look inside.
And we welcome Ann-Marie Saccurato to Edmonton, the City of Champions. She's a tremendous fighter with a tremendous record. She's tough.
Hi. God, I'm thrilled to be here. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go right now. When we got the call about Eliza being injured and the WBC had asked if we were interested, I said, hell yeah, game on, as soon as my manager Luigi told me about it. So it's been a belt that I've wanted for a while. I've been wanting to be a part of Rock and Sock and a ring of their own for quite some time. So I'm amped, and I couldn't be more excited.
Now the WBC world champion, Edmonton's own Jelena Majerovic. Yeah.
Thank you everybody for coming. You know, this fight means a lot to me. I'm moving up in weight to fight for the WBC lightweight belt. And it's an honor to fight for the WBC as I already have the super featherweight belt.
This is the greatest assemblage of women boxers ever on one card.
It is called the Border War as 3 American girls will take on 3 Canadian girls for world heavyweight, actually not a world heavyweight, okay?
World title.
3-2. It is called the Border War as 3 American girls will take on 3 Canadian girls for world titles, and Jelena Mirjanovic of Edmonton will be taking on her opponent for the WBC lightweight title.
Yeah.
Your opponent's name is and from where?
It's Ann-Marie Saccurato from New York. What all of us have, it's a killer instinct, or else we wouldn't be in boxing. You know, we all, it's not that we want to hurt our opponent, it's just that's what we've been trained to do. And you know, after the fights, you see everybody after the fights, they give each other a hug, and it's all that. It's between the rounds and between the bells that we're out to kill, but after that, it's not. It's, you know, camaraderie. We're friends.
Jelena is going to win because Jelena, pound for pound, is the biggest puncher in female boxing. I think she's got more experience than Ann-Marie, and I just think she punches too hard. I'll give it, won't go past 6.
I've had 11 knockouts to my record. In 19 fights, I've had 11 knockouts.
There's an exchange of blows and a left hand on Mirjanovic, puts Francesca Alcander down to the mat.
there's a lot of disadvantages coming in for this for Saccurato. Saccurato, every time she seems to have stepped up in level of competition, Belinda Laraquente, Eliza Olson, she doesn't win. She's coming into the backyard of Jelena Mijenovic. Mijenovic is like the governor of Edmonton. So Mijenovic has been in arguably with a better level of competition. She's a heavier hitter. Saccurato, though, looks in fantastic shape. She's a little bigger than Jelena. So I see, you know, on paper, this is going to be it's a pick'em fight. It's not a fight that I would want to bet.
She hasn't faced me yet. Enough said. She hasn't seen me. She hasn't seen the likes of me. She hasn't seen what I have to bring to the table. She doesn't know what's in here. She hasn't seen anything yet. We'll see Saturday night.
I felt better immediately, so whoever those people were...
The day before the fight, I'm feeling crazy energy inside of me. Antsy, my body wants to go. I'm rested that day. It's my day my body relaxes a little bit. So that energy all built up, and you just feel those muscles, they want to move. Just try to relax them, mentally stay focused on what task is at hand.
And I don't care if I never grow up. Don't want to shrink in my suit. Don't want to live just to serve someone. Bone dry, I'd rather die.
I'm thinking mentally about what I'm gonna do in that ring the next day. I'm seeing it. I'm envisioning it. I envision all 10 rounds.
It's time to think back to my hometown and my sad skinny self standing around. Wait, watch, wish for something to happen. Trying and searching for something fantastic. Come on! We've been here before. Stood up at the door. Holding secrets we never say. Hey, don't hang your head. Feel the breeze instead. Fear no shadow. Don't feel no shame.
All right, we're going to start with the official weigh-in portion tonight. Starting with Jelena Mijenovic.
133 even.
133 Mijenovic.
Ann Saccurato, Ann-Marie Saccurato.
Step on there and stand still for me. 135.
135, Saccurato.
This is to set it off, and this is one to lick it off.
Jesus, today is my day.
Today is my day.
I want to be a champ.
I want to be a champ.
Live big in my heart.
Live big in my heart.
And help me to succeed.
And help me to succeed.
From this day on.
From this day on.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Ah, we ready to go now. Let's go.
When we first got here on Thursday, Ann-Marie was very stressed. But that's normal. That's a normal thing. You get stressed, you get cranky. You're not eating the way you want to be able to eat, and everything was a little stressful. But now that the weigh-ins are over, Ann-Marie usually loads up on her carbs in the morning, eats freely. Anything she wants to eat, she can have. You know, it helps you mentally as well as you want to put on some pounds back before the fight and be well-fueled. Now it's game time. Now it's a happy stress.
Go make bacon.
Made in bacon, that would be.
Y mira, me salgo allá,
¿ves?
Wow. You got a school bus, gotta go take some people to school. Here we go.
You want the teacher coming to take somebody to school. La televisión, la televisión.
Wait a minute. I just want to go down and see what it looks like for like a second.
Pero está solo eso.
Stay nice and relaxed. Slip any shot coming. Block it, counter. Block to the body, counter. Be nice and slick. Frustrate the hell out of them. They can't catch what they can't see. When you're getting your hands wrapped before a fight, that's when you really feel it's on. And there's just so many emotions going inside of you. Your intensity goes up 10 notches, your focus goes up 10 notches, and okay, this is the final countdown. This is it, this is the moment. It's you, it's your coach, it's that bond. It's like taking all those hours of training, all the sweat, all the sacrifice, all the knowledge that you've learned and gained, and wrap it up, put it right here nice and tight. It feels great. It feels incredible. I feel unstoppable. I feel like I have these two weapons of mass destruction, these two bricks that I can use any way I want. I can paint a picture with them. I can do some serious damage with them. I can end the fight with them. I can play with them. I can have fun with them. Do whatever I want.
Beautiful to watch, Hector.
Thank you, sir.
It's the best.
Oh, it's intense. It's intense. It's just amazing. A pressure cooker, you could call it, hey? Because the people all down there dressed in their nice high heels or their fine suits, they'll be yelling and getting right into it.
Well, the crowd's going to be going crazy for Jelena. She is, like I said, this is Jelenaville, the city of Edmonton. And when she comes out in that ring, the fans will be going crazy. And that influences judges. I don't care where you are. When Jelena throws a punch, and maybe it didn't quite hit, the fans go nuts and the judge say, and that's how boxing works.
4, 3, 2.
The scene is the Shaw Event Center in Edmonton, Canada, the mecca of women's boxing, where tonight, six women will vie for 3 world titles as they prepare to enter a ring of their own.
Let's get right to our main event. What does Saccurato bring special to the table, though, that Mijenovic has never seen before?
Probably how hungry she is. She took this fight on only 1 month's notice, and she's fighting at a career low of 135 pounds. Why is she doing that? Because she's hungry. She wants to win, and she is here to win.
When a boxer steps in the ring, it's different than almost any other sport. First of all, obviously, there's no team sport. There's nobody behind you. There's nobody in front of you. All you know is there's somebody on the other corner that wants to kill you. It's kill or be killed. And there's nothing else like that in the sporting world. This is something that's, you know, if on its barest levels is a throwback to Roman gladiators.
Something happens when I walk into that ring. That bell rings and I feel huge. I feel like a giant in the ring, unstoppable. When I'm fighting, I feel 10 times bigger and stronger than what I actually am.
Ann-Marie Saccurato from New York, making her way into the ring here tonight. Coming in with an 11-1 record, 2 draws. Her only loss coming to Belinda Larraquente in a split decision. All right, the ring walk beginning right now. Jelena Majinovic, 11 knockouts, one of the highest knockout percentages of any female fighter active today. She's got a very formidable opponent right in front of her tonight. And Ann-Marie Saccurato, somebody knows how to spit in the eye of adversity. Entire arena up on their feet here as Jelena Majinovic makes her way into the ring. Saccurato looking like a bull in the china shop in the other corner right now. Looking to get out there and very calm is Majinovic. Both fighters fighting in orthodox style. Saccurato up on her feet. Stick and jab. Majinovic starts fast, as she always does, comes out with a three-punch combination. Certainly caught Saccurato's attention there. Good combination by Saccurato. Saccurato with the right-hand lead, followed by a left. Right now, Majinovic, uncharacteristically slow here in the first round. Keep in mind, Saccurato's never been the 10-round distance, been 8 rounds only once. Oh, Majinovic with a back to Saccurato, holding onto one hand, and turns her back on Saccurato. Saccurato showing that New York swagger's not just New York swagger here. Of course, she's trained by Hector Roca, famed trainer of Arturo Gatti. Got Hillary Swank ready for Million Dollar Baby. Oh, big left hook by Majinovic.
Saccurato fighting it off, but her legs were a little wobbly after that left hook.
Thank you. 10th and final round. A lot of rounds very close, could have gone either way. Crowd is going wild right now, trying to urge on Maginovic.
So far, Ann-Marie's...
Maginovic, big combination right now, rocks Saccurato. Maginovic slipping the shots right now. Showing good defense and power here in the 10th. She knows this fight's on the line. Saccurato trying to get a combination in here.
Come on, work, baby! Work!
It's a very exciting round.
Good combination now by Maginovic. Saccurato hasn't really scored anything, Ann-Marie. Getting tagged right now by Maginovic at the end, and a good finish, big finish tonight for Maginovic. Is it enough to win the title?
Very, very close round.
Unofficially, I've got the fight 95-95. Jill's got it the same way. We see this fight dead even in a draw. A lot of concern looks in both corners. Both fighters embracing now in the middle of the ring in what was a tremendous battle. It's going to be interesting to see how it plays out. Judges really taking a lot of time right now tabulating their scores.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a decision. Judge Ron Hayter scores it 96-94 for Ann Saccurato. Judge Usman Ali scores it 96-94 for Jelena Mirjanovic. And Judge Metcalf scores it 96-94 for the winner by split decision, Ann-Marie Saccurato.
Ann-Marie Saccurato comes into the backyard of Jelena Mirjanovic and pulls a big upset here.
One of the most exciting fights I've ever seen in my life. Ann-Marie, how did you feel?
Oh my God, it was unbelievable. She's great competition. She threw a lot of good stuff at me, had good inside game, and she made me push for everything that I had inside. And
she's a force to be reckoned with, so you know, I definitely give her props for overcoming everything. And you know, I stepped up, I wanted to fight, and you know, we got to take steps in order to make fights and make women's boxing a reality. So, you know, I definitely feel comfortable at 130, and you know what? She's tough.
Let me tell you, my hat is off to her. My hat is off to her. And this is the competition that the sport needs, you know, and hopefully this can be a step forward for the sport. It's about the sport. It's about building it up, building the respect for it. And we just need more fights like this out there.
Look at the sport of boxing as the vehicle for us. It's a platform, as it were, to get a message across about women, about women's roles in society, about lesbians, about, I mean, there's so many things we're kind of working on all at once. Boxing just happens to be the way we've chosen to do it because it's something that we're good at.
I'm in that ring and it's me as the athlete, it's me as the female boxer, it's me as also gay lesbian that's out, the out athlete. And I take great pride in that. With that, I think there's a lot of responsibility. And, or at least I hold myself responsible to being able to display strength and confidence and having the ability to instill that in others through my performance in the ring and what people know of me outside of the ring.